Hello and welcome. Yeah, long time no see. Here's a video. I'm actually making this video because there's a comment on one of these shorts. Paul Richings asked regarding the setup of how I put the cameras together that I bought the Canon XA70s. And I figured I might as well show you how I'm going to rig the cameras for my intended use and doing run and gun ENG shooting. So let's begin. I'm also recording this on a Canon XA70, so the video quality is going to be comparable, and of course I'm wearing a lav mic that's plugged into the camera right now, so this is the same audio quality you would get from the whole setup I'm about to do. So the lovely Canon XA70 camcorder, prosumer camera, professional video recording device, if you want to call it that. I bought these because these were a very good price point. They're only $3,200 Canadian, whatever that is in USD, 28,000. And I bought these to replace the very old Canon HFS100s, which I'm staring at right now on my storage shelf. I've had those cameras since 2010, so I mean, an upgrade was needed. But yeah, this is the basic camera. Side hand strap, record button at the back, zoom rocker, which I've actually disabled, a custom function ring, which I use for doing zooms because I find when you zoom this way, you have a little more play with it. The obvious front lens cover and the screen. And the other thing that comes with this is the top handle. So the top handle slots into the cold shoe, and then you tighten down these capacitive, I think is the term for when it's stuck in place. Spring mounted screws, which are very fun to try and get in, especially on the fly. And now the camera has a top handle. So when you're running around, you can just hold it like this and not have it, awkwardly in the palm grip like so. And of course, zoom rocker up here, record controls, locking switch, so you don't accidentally stop your recording mid-record, because that's always fun. And of course, audio controls in the little box right there. So now, the question that Paul was asking is, how do I power these cameras? Now, of course, they come with the standard, This is a Canon. Did I cover the label on this thing? This is a Canon BP820 battery pack. It's gonna focus there. And these are the standard batteries that come with the cameras. The problem is they only last for about an hour and a half, which when you're doing all day shooting and running around, that's not sufficient. Now, of course, Canon does sell larger batteries and proprietary batteries, but they're expensive. And there are far cheaper, just as efficient solutions out there. And the benefit of these cameras is their charging port is a USB Type-C charging port. In fact, this is the charging cable that comes with the cameras. This is the Canon PDE1 battery charger, which is, of course, AC 120 volt power in, which then translates to a USB Type-C charging cable, which does the DC power in. And what was the conversion on this? Output 5 volts at 3 amps, 15 watt, or output 9 volts at 3 amps at 27 watt. So the math is I had to have at least a 27 watt power supply to power this, which I went and purchased. Basius makes specifically 30 watt chargers, which have one USB-C and two type A. And the real nice thing is it has a low percentage meter on there. So this is the power source for the camera. And all it requires is plugging this into here. Problem, how do you connect this battery to a camera which has no mounting ports on it? And the only thing I have on here is a 1/4-20, and then of course a cold shoe, which I need the cold shoe for other things. So, the joys of knowing people who do custom fabrication. Chris, who is one of the co-founders of Broken CRT Productions, is also a sheet metal and, general metal fabricator. And I asked very nicely if he could make me what I call these battery thongs, even though they're just a battery holder. And through his lovely engineering, this little piece here goes under the camera and requires a little bit of tricky installation. And I'm eventually gonna work on having these all fully kitted out and ready to go in the camera bags, because right now I have one bag that holds all three cameras I bought, and I have to tear it down every single time. So the battery thong T-bar thing, whatever you want to call it, it mounts to the quarter 20 below the camera. But the other fun little thing that we did is, because of course we know I have to mount these cameras to a tripod sometimes, and I may not have power access to plug in the AC to DC power cable that comes with it. So we also, I'm gonna put my phone, we have a quarter 20 mount below there. So any tripod plate I have can be mounted on here, and the camera can still be powered by the battery. Because unfortunately, they don't make batteries that have quarter 20s in the bottom of them. They make, I've bought them before for our previous camera kit. You can buy batteries that are kind of like V-mount, but it's not the same mounting system, and it has a spring-loaded mechanism. You just clap a battery on by screwing in the mounting plate into a quarter 20 on the bottom of the camera, but then there's nothing on the bottom side of the battery bank. So this goes into here. And that's unfortunately there's a bit of a lip on the screw, just because like it's not perfectly flush with the metal, but I mean that's fine because there's nothing really here to worry about. And then yeah, a short little USB-C cable, and I usually plug it on the left side, run it around the front of the camera, and then plug it in there. So now I'll turn this on just to show. So right now it says there is 36 minutes of battery life, but then plugging in to the power bank, it changes to DC in. And so long as the power bank has power, this camera will be powered. And the test I did is briefly, these will operate for about 11 hours just on the power bank, because I ran it for an hour and only drained about 9% of the battery. So that should be giving me, yeah, 10 hours battery bank, another hour and a half on the actual internal battery. And of course, also you can swap these out and put new ones in there. So I mean, I really hope a camera doesn't be operational for more than 11 hours, but hey, you never know. But yeah, that's the basic functionality of getting the camera up and running. The batteries aren't too heavy, as a nice little bit of weight to balance the camera because it's bottom heavy. And of course, we have the edges on these rounded out. So like you have a nice little holder here, and you're also not gonna gouge your hands, because the first version of these, well, these are the same one, but the first assembly, rough cut, whatever, still had all the rough edges. So like I had to wrap these in gaff tape to make sure no one cut their hands while holding a camera. But yeah, that is basically how I plug in and power on the camera. But of course, there's a little more to it than that in terms of the functionality for these. The basic use scenario for these cameras will just be for live event run and gunning. So one option is either A, you know, I have a little shotgun mic here with a mono to dual XLR adapter. So I can't do this with one hand holding something. So of course for basic everyday use of this camera, and especially if I'm getting a wide shot at an event, this is the setup I use. And of course now I have to try and thread this. So lock this down, and then these just plug into their corresponding inputs, and I actually have one running quieter than the other. So I have a safety channel. So I think I run this at Yeah, channel one is at 4, and channel three is at channel two is at 3. So that just gives me a little bit of safety and flexibility where if there's a very loud boom or something, I don't blow out the audio channel. So that's the first case scenario for using these. The second case scenario, which I haven't fully yet bought into because I have not yet purchased the other pieces I require for this, but this camera has 4 individual audio channels. So that means you could have 4 people mic'd up or with microphones. And then of course you have the flexibility to adjust all their audio channels in post. You're not limited to, you know, if one person talks too loud, one person talks too soft, you can A, adjust it here as best you can. But then B, in post, you can mix it a little bit better if you need to. Now, the problem is, how do you get 4 audio channels into this thing? With a little bit of finessing and usual jerry-rigging. So there's a mic terminal input on here for channels 3 and 4, and then the inputs up here are channels 1 and 2. The setup that's going to eventually happen will be, there will be 2 XLR inputs on here, which feed to more of these little Sennheiser transmitters, which I have to get more of these. That's the part that I haven't bought yet. but the plugins on here will just stick out kind of like so from the camera. That's fine. Doesn't affect your hand operation. If your hand's here, you're not going to get nicked by it. But then the other problem is how you connect channels 3 and 4. That required a little bit of jerry-rigging. So first off, I went and bought from Ulanzi, these are their VL49 RGB lights, and I actually have one right now, it's kind of a key light to fill my face in. But these are just simple little USB powered lights that also have cold shoe mounts on all the sides of them. And I keep forgetting how bright these are. This is only 50%. I'm gonna blind myself looking at it, but yeah, 50%, and like, it just illuminates the hell out of me. So these are quite powerful. They're USB, and also I can change the colors because this is just color temperature, but they have a full RGB range on them as well. So this goes into here. If I can actually get this slide in, because these are a little finicky sometimes, because these top handles don't like, it's a cold shoe, but it likes to play weird sometimes. Now, one thing I bought these for is also because, like, I'm hoping to leave these on the top handles just so it's not taking the parts out, because like, there's 2 screws here, the piece, I won't lose it. but that's fine, because how these work, I can arrange them in whatever direction needs to be done. So the theory is, I take 2 of the receivers, similar to what I'm using right now for my microphone, and I would plug these into the cold shoes on here, and either, you know, face them forward or face them to the side, whatever works best for the scenario we are working with, and then lock them in. And now I have my extra 3 and 4 audio channels. But then the problem is these are fun because they use stereo inputs on them, and I need to split the audio. And I know from past experience, if you plug a mono cable into a stereo outlet, you get a lot of hissing and noise on the other channel not plugged in. So enter cable jerry-rigging. So this is a simple 3.5mm to mono splitting cable. I had to get RCA ends, which are now covered with RCA to stereo adapters. And how this works is you plug the 3.5mm into the mic terminal, which then divides this into channels 3 and 4, red for 3, because it's 3 letters, blue for 4, because it's 4 letters. That was the only real way I could do the system and remember it. And then all you gotta do is plug this in. And then when you factor in all the transmitters or receivers will be on this, and then the transmitters, you can have one at an event, someone on a host mic, and then 3 people holding handheld mics that'll all be transmitting to the same transmitters. And that's the full build out of these cameras. I also did buy, for the Danny Baranowski video, or live event rather, the cameras were all transmitting wirelessly. So I also have Hollyland video transmitters for these. So like these cameras can broadcast wirelessly back to a host station. But of course, when you're doing ENG gathering, you wouldn't have all the stuff on here and I can take pieces off and whatnot. But yeah, before I sit here and start making any more rambling, that is how to set these cameras. So basic Canon XA70, proprietary battery installed, external third-party power bank installed, plug them through DC power. And then for my use case scenario, if I'm doing event coverage, which I really want to start doing again because I miss it, we can now interview up to four people or have four people on camera and mic'd on camera. So the host will have the lavalier mic because they're not going to change from camera to camera. And then the interviewees can all carry be given a handheld mic and do that. So that's that. Nothing else really to discuss. I'd almost love to have more of these, but at the same time, it's like I don't really need more than three of them because I don't do that much multicam shooting. What might potentially happen is I will eventually get more. There's rumor of a Canon C70 Mark II coming out, so that'd be nice to have for the glamour shots. Because like, I'm gonna clip footage of the Danny Baranowski concert in here. Like any of the up close shots are shot with my Canon R5, so I'd love to have a proper film camera to get those shots and actually worry about having like a nice close up glamour shot, while all the running gunners can just use these and just get the general shots as needed. That's everything. I feel like I just burned through that really fast with no script in mind, just rambling. So yeah, thank you to, that was Paul, right? As I will go back here, yeah, Paul Rishings. That answered your question. I apologize, I made a long video for this, but it's also just like, I may as well just talk about the whole camera rigging. And that's it. I'm gonna try and get more content out soon, just, there's a lot on my mind right now. So anyways, thank you for watching. Have a good day and see you next time.